Many people don't realize this, but the world's most successful scams are those that seem so inconspicuous that you would never even think about it. AKA, these scams disguise themselves as actual, just normal things that lots of people do, but simply, when you do it, you don't understand exactly how much you're losing for how much you're putting in. So for example, this wouldn't be just as obvious as some random tech support scammer who would call you on your phone asking for your social security number and credit card information. No, it would be a lot more hard to identify. So a good example of this would be something called a Ponzi scheme, or basically also known as a pyramid scheme. What's going on is, the actual thing of a pyramid scheme is not necessarily illegal because the people that get themselves involved are willingly do it and not being forced to, but overall they're actually losing more than what they're getting out of, and they're benefiting the actual creators of the scheme more than they're getting anything back for themselves. This is the same type of scam that we're gonna look into today, and it's the most prevalent scam on YouTube, and has been the most prevalent scam on YouTube for the last 10 years. And this is the scam of YouTube networks. Back in 2010, there were basically no such thing as YouTube networks. The only thing was you could create a YouTube account and pretty much just make videos that were very poorly edited, very low quality, whatever. The genre of gaming, which is overall the main genre of videos that require this new type of thing to happen in the future, didn't really exist until later on. But as more people started picking up careers simply by playing games, the use of YouTube networks, aka signing a contract with a YouTube company, a different YouTube company other than YouTube, in order to make sure that you could legally record video games, which could technically be considered copyrighted content, and you can get away with that and make money at the same time. So when this happened, everyone wanted to be with a YouTube network. Hell, even I was the one who tried to get so hard into a YouTube network known as Fullscreen, which was one of the most popular YouTube networks back in the day. Back on my very first channel, when I only had 500 subs, I applied several times just to get into Fullscreen.
I almost showed you my surprise that's behind this. Oh my gosh. Yes, I have a surprise behind this.
Because back then there was an actual point to being a part of a YouTube network, because YouTube itself was actually a considerable amount younger than it is today. They didn't entirely know how to operate while people were simply recording copyrighted content such as gameplays, and also somehow figure out a way to pay them money legally. But on top of that, if you were part of a YouTube network, you got all of these extra privileges, such as a custom channel banner, a custom channel background. At a time, you couldn't even make custom thumbnails unless you had a partnership with a certain company, so that would basically be your ticket into YouTube success. It came to a point that even if you weren't a gaming channel necessarily, you would pretty much need to have a YouTube partnership with some third-party company in order to get successful. There was just literally no way around it. Now, some things that these YouTube third-party companies would offer you would be something of great use. Of course, they would offer you protection from false copyright claims from potential owners of content within your videos. They would also give you all the privileges of which I mentioned before that YouTube itself would not be able to give you. And basically, it would make you look way more official and would show up officially on your Social Blade profile. Pretty much all the big boys on YouTube had this. And pretty much if you were on YouTube at the time, that was like your main goal, just to get the YouTube partnership with a company. Now, of course, all good things have to come with some kind of price, and this definitely was not an exception for YouTube partnerships. Whenever you did sign a contract with a YouTube company, a YouTube third-party company, also known as a partnership, you would have to deal with certain catches, which some people actually didn't want to get involved with. For the first part, you would lose a certain percentage of the amount of money that you made. Some networks took as much as 30 to 40% of all of the money that you were generating off of YouTube ad revenue. And since YouTube automatically takes 45% of your revenue anyways, that means you end up with only having around 20 to 30% of your organic YouTube ad revenue. Not to mention the fact that 9 out of 10 networks made you sign a lock-in contract, which pretty much meant that the moment that you signed that contract, your channel's life and soul would be given away to this company and would be passed down into the hands of this company, and pretty much you would have to stay with them for at least 1 to 2 years. So they pretty much locked you into a jail cell, whether you liked it or not. And like I said, for back then, 2012, 2013, we're talking the golden years of YouTube. Okay, this is the gold rush of everyone's life-worthy dreams of ever having prospects of being big on YouTube. This is back in the day when This was all worth it. Nobody cared. Everyone just wanted to be successful and get those extra perks and privileges that you would get out of having a partnership. But as time went on, things started to change, and thus things that led to the downhill spiral of the whole concept of a YouTube partnership. First of all, YouTube changed the entire layout of their website, so trying to have a partnership so you could have a custom background and banner was pretty much useless, since everyone was given that option by default, regardless of how many subs you had. Also, YouTube made it so that you could have any custom thumbnail for as many subscribers as you had without having a YouTube partnership as well, so pretty much all of the main perks that a YouTube partnership came with in those regards were pretty much useless. And essentially, long story short, as YouTube got older and more successful as a company, they pretty much started figuring their crap out, making it easier for copyright issues to be settled out. Gaming became a very normal thing, which no one had problems with copyright with. Gaming companies and gaming producers obviously never had problems with people recording their games for the most part, so pretty much the whole point behind going into a network and having a partnership just for that extra security became more and more useless as the days went on. It was just something that you no longer needed. Like, I mean, for example, as the year 2016 to 2017 rolled around, there were no copyright issues if you wanted to be a gaming YouTube channel. You never had to worry about that. You didn't have to be part of a partnership in order to get YouTube thumbnails. Everyone automatically had a custom YouTube banner. YouTube offered you so many of the tools that you used to only be able to get through a YouTube partnership just automatically through YouTube's own system and own service. So pretty much, the only thing that partnerships were left worthy of doing was just to give you the rights of copyright for your videos. And still to this very day, there are these same companies that still take the money of unknowing, willing, small YouTube channels that simply do not know better and pretty much do not provide anything for them in return. Let's be real here, guys. YouTube networks are completely and utterly useless. The only reason why the whole concept of a YouTube partnership was even invented was because back in the day, YouTube definitely did not have all of the features and all of their stuff figured out for making the experience of being a YouTuber to be 100% satisfactory. It was kind of like a jailbreak option for your iPhone. The whole reason why it was invented was mainly just because Apple itself didn't offer enough freedom to do whatever you wanted with your phone, so jailbreaking would basically be a backdoor to just be able to do that. Or a real far-off example would be Single Player Commands Mod for all those Minecraft boomers out there who remember that, who gave you the option to just basically, you know, do commands in single player Minecraft and, well, pretty much do whatever you wanted. But then as Minecraft grew up and pretty much had thousands and thousands of updates, they added in this feature which pretty much made single player commands utterly useless, since now all those commands are just pretty much readily available in the game anyways. So anyways, without blabbering on for 4 hours, you get the point. That's why YouTube networks no longer have an ideal purpose on YouTube. But the problem is, they still exist. And still, people who are ignorant to the fact of how unbelievably useless it is to sign away 30 to 50% of your entire income to some YouTube company are still doing it to this day. And the main reason why I am making this video is that I finally got out of a YouTube brand company partnership that I had for the last 4 years with a company that I'm not gonna name the name of, just for the sake of this video. I don't want people to go and just hate on them or whatever. But overall, the entire experience I had with this company was nothing short of a straight up scam. These people took tens of thousands of dollars from my bank account out of my YouTube paycheck every single month for literally nothing in return. And the problem was, it was all my fault. I gave them the permission to do that. Back when I first started this channel, I still didn't really think the networks were completely useless, and I still tried my hardest to get into one, in which I was forced to sign a 1-year lock-in contract. I was stuck with these people for 4 years, as every single time I tried to get out, every single year, you had to wait just to try to tell them that you no longer wanted to be with this company. They always gave some makeshift excuse on why the contract already renewed and you had to wait till next year. From something as stupid as just,
"Oh, you have to wait until this specific month to do it," or, "You were 5 days late, now you have to wait till next year to do it again."
It was clear that this entire company's main goal was to continue leeching off of my success and pretty much offer me nothing in return. Mainly the only perks that these partnerships give you nowadays is simply just stuff around the lines of a built-in YouTube analytics section, which pretty much offers you the same thing that you'll find in any YouTube studio, pretty much not even necessary. A community of people which you can collaborate with, which you can find on YouTube itself or any other of the thousands of websites that offer that anyways. Most of them will claim that they have free to use material like songs and music and videos that you can use, but in reality it's just stock footage that you can get for free from anywhere else. And they also claim that they will come to you with brand deals and give you opportunities to make money like that. Well, within the 4 years that I was with this company, guess what? They offered me one brand deal, of which I almost didn't even get paid for, by the way. Not only did they underprice the brand deal, I had to negotiate them just to get it to a reasonable price when I had over 400,000 subscribers. But they took over 3.5 months to even get around to paying me for it afterwards. After 45 individual emails to this company, going back and forth just simply asking them where the frick my money was, they finally ended up paying me only half the amount that was agreed upon in one of the previous emails. And their main excuse behind this was simply,
"Oh, your video only got 140,000 views 15 days after we wanted it to."
I mean, does it really fucking matter, like, when the video got the views? Like, who the fuck cares? And also, when I finally contacted them 4 years later successfully, telling them that I wanted to leave their network, they finally agreed to it and helped me through the process of doing that, which I was actually genuinely surprised and happy over, because I personally thought that they were going to once again pull some kind of tactic to try to keep me in there for yet another year, and everything was fine and dandy until 1 month, they didn't even pay me my YouTube paycheck. I pretty much went that entire month, which was actually only a couple of months ago, without having any money in my bank account and being late to over 7 different bills I had to pay for that month. And since I had already had some issues with my bills in the previous month, exclusively regarding my actual house payments, my landlord actually told me that I was super close to being fucking evicted, all because this stupid-ass company didn't decide to pay me on time. So, fast forward a couple more dozen emails, just frantically trying to contact them. They had no phone number of where I was able to be able to just talk to them about all this crap, having to wait 3 days just for any kind of response whatsoever. They finally ended up paying me a whole month later on, with the excuse of a slight confusion due to the fact of you leaving the network. Yeah, because that's a perfect excuse on why my entire livelihood should be put in stake. And after all that, when all this was finally settled, everything seemed to finally be looking up, and I was almost free from the clutches of this crazy ass company. On the day that they said that YouTube would no longer show that I was partnered with them on my YouTube Studio tab, well, that day went by and it still said I was partnered with them. So after 2 days of this, I was like, okay, is this like a glitch or something? So I once again emailed them for like literally the 60th time for them just to reply back saying, "Oh, I forgot." You can't even make this stuff up, my man. Like, seriously. Without naming the company, let's just put it this way. This is a company that's one of the most well-known YouTube partnership companies. They're probably worth tens of millions of dollars, and they can't even fulfill paying the livelihood of their creators. They forget to do things such as removing them from their network after they officially release them from the contract. It's just absolutely ridiculous. So at the end of the day, I finally got out of this network. So if you are thinking about joining a YouTube network anytime soon, just do yourself a favor and don't. I know some of these partnership networks are using a new tactic to influence smaller creators to try to join them by using the fact that YouTube now requires you to have 1,000 subscribers as an excuse for them to try to reel you in by saying, "Oh, we'll give you money even though you don't have 1,000 subscribers." Well, guess what? They're not going to be giving you money. They're going to be taking your money in return for nothing. And you'll be stuck with it for a year to 2 years straight. It's just crazy why YouTube even allows this to happen anymore. It's honestly the same exact thing as a pyramid scheme, because you are willingly going into it. It's technically not illegal, but they are literally at the same time just taking your money for nothing in return. They are literally using you to profit themselves. Now, am I gonna say that all of the YouTube networks in all of existence have always been like this and have never actually wholesomely tried to benefit their creators in return rather than just themselves? Obviously not. But nowadays, in 2020, as we go into the new year, 9 out of 10 are. And even the ones that aren't are probably not making enough money to even stay in business anyways. So this video was kind of like a long-awaited thing since MatPat made his video complaining about the whole situation that happened with over $1.7 million being taken by an MCN, which is the same thing as a YouTube partnership company. So because of that, I wanted to share my own experiences on why YouTube partnerships are a complete scam, and it really took until this very moment where I thought it would be the best time to finally whip up this video. As a final note, don't join a YouTube network, just go independent. There is simply no reason for you to be a part of a YouTube network. There is just no absolute reason whatsoever. They'll give you the minimum amount of perks that is possible. They are nothing but a thing of the past, and that is what they shall remain to be. I mean, hell, you can't even request a YouTube verification badge anymore unless you have 100k subs anyways, which you used to be able to do under 100k if you were partnered with a network. So that's like the last thing the networks had to offer you. Now they can't even do that. However, if you've watched all the way through this video up to this point, then you clearly must like me to some extent, so I'm offering you a chance to become a partner of the Tekkit Realm, and I'll tell you why the Tekkit Realm partnership is different. Because the Tekkit Realm's partnership, which is available for anyone, does not lock you into a contract, and it actually gives you stuff in return. And basically, all you have to do is go over to the website. I don't take a certain percent of your YouTube revenue or anything like that. It's just a flat fee every single month. And like I said, no lock-in contract. You could leave whenever you want if you're dissatisfied, but of course you're not going to be because it's literally the best. So if there's any partnership I would recommend, without being as biased as I possibly can, I would say probably mine. But other than that, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see all of you guys in the next video. As long as you don't get scammed in between now and then. I hope you don't. Okay? So please just don't. Goodbye.